Memories of the events of 15th April 2023, when Mafia brothers Atiq Ahmed and Mohammed Ashraf were shot dead by three youngsters dressed up as journalists right after they exited a hospital where they were taken to for medical checkup by Prayagraj police, have again come alive. The reason? The report of a five-member judicial commission formed by the state government to probe into the sequence of events leading to the killing of the Mafia brothers has submitted its report. And months after the report was submitted to the state government, the UP government has tabled the report in the Uttar Pradesh Assembly on Thursday. In the report tabled in the Assembly, the Judicial Commission has made a slew of observations and recommendations about the sequence of events, along with almost giving a clean chit to the UP police. To begin with, it has said that it cannot be concluded that the killing of the Mafia brothers was a premeditated conspiracy on part of the state government. It has also said that it cannot be concluded that the UP police's negligence led to the killing of the Mafia brothers. Further, it has given a slew of recommendations to the state government, the medical department, the UP police, and also to the media persons covering such events. Significantly, it has told the UP police and the state government to ensure that such hardened criminals, including ex-MPs and MLAs, be transported to hospitals that are empaneled with the state government. For this purpose, it has recommended that the state government forms a list of such hospitals, including government hospitals, community health centers, and primary health centers. Significantly, the Judicial Commission has recommended to the UP police that it be tried that such hardened criminals, including ex-MLAs and MPs, be first taken to a medical facility within the police lines of a particular district for a medical checkup. It's another issue that most of the police lines across the state lack such medical facilities. However, the commission has recommended that if in case such hardened criminals need to be taken to medical facilities for a medical checkup physically, it be ensured that the UP police provides timely information to the authorities of such a facility well in advance. It is also said that the premises of such a facility be cordoned off and media be allowed entry not beyond such a cordon. The most significant part of the Judicial Commission's report is, however, their recommendations to the media persons covering such events. The Judicial Commission has asked the media persons covering such sensational events to exercise discipline and restraint. Significantly, it has said that if media persons are arriving in a particular district to cover such an incident from outside a state, they should provide prior information to the district information officer about their arrival, their organization, and other details via an email. It has further recommended to the media persons that they always carry their Aadhaar card and the identity cards during the time of coverage. It has further said that the UP police can ask media persons covering such events to produce their Aadhaar cards or their identity cards during the coverage. And if in case a media person covering such an event fails to produce his identity card or an Aadhaar card, he or she is liable for an action from the authorities. However, the action has not been defined by the Judicial Commission in its report. Most importantly, it has said that live coverage of such sensational events be disallowed by the state government. This is also in connection with the coverage of the transportation of Atiq Ahmed from Sabarmati jail in Ahmedabad to Naini Central Jail in Prayagraj, grabbing a lot of eyeballs and attracting criticism from media critics about the way and the manner in which it was covered. The Judicial Commission has said that live broadcasts of such transportation and sensational events be stopped completely. We'll keep bringing you more updates around the issue. This is Shikha Salaria for The Print. Thanks for watching.